All right, here we are. We have Bandit again. We are doing downs. Now, I want to get into a couple specifics here. when I do a lot of the training, I usually have a leash dragon. Now, he's a six-month-old puppy. He doesn't understand English. He doesn't know the rules. He's going to continually do stuff wrong because, well, we haven't really taught him what to do right. In my house, when I had a puppy, he's 10 months old now, but I got him at 4 months. It was a process to get him to where he is right now without a leash, upstairs, just hanging out. Because if I were to chase him around when he did something wrong, then it turns into a game. And I didn't want me chasing him or constantly reaching for his collar and making those things into some type of negative association. Now with this guy, I'm gonna show you right quick before I even get started on the official training, which is downstays here, that he, when you reach for him, he ducks. He's like, whoa. And this kind of maybe coincides with that, you know, when he's getting stuff wrong, when he's chewing on something, we finally catch him, then we do something that he doesn't like, maybe put him in a crate, or, you know, yell at him, or you know, what have you. What we want to do, we want to get him comfortable with us reaching for him. At the same time, he's going to get into stuff. To help us out, if you see, let him drag a leash. And I tell some of the owners that when they have a new puppy, it's ideal to let a leash drag like that. And usually what I get is, well, what if they chew it? You know, with it, you do it. And in my mind is, you have a puppy, you have to supervise this puppy constantly. And it's not just yours. It's every puppy that you've ever come around needs constant attention and supervision. And if the dog happens to chew through it, that lets me know that you're not watching the dog or they wasn't watching the dog. So you have a puppy, they need constant. You have to ask yourself constantly, where is the dog at? I don't see him. Where is he at? You have to do that constantly. Where is he at? He doesn't know the rules. Okay, so we're going to do, I'm going to show you that little reach, what he does, you know, with the reach. And then we're going to go into some downs. So, okay, come on, Bubba. See, like right now, if he were to get this item here, I don't know if you can see it. If he were to get this item, I have no problem with stepping on his leash so he can't go anywhere and just remove it from him. Come on. See, and just remove it from him. You know, and that's what happens. I know this is a small little area compared to your big house, but it helps without doing just like this. Remember what I said with the reaching, just like this. He's constantly ducking, he's folding his ears, he's squinting, you know, he's doing all these things, you know, when I reach for him. And then I go and start chasing him around, you know, and then it's a game, you know, it turns into a game. So what I suggest is leash. That you avoid all this stuff here, you avoid that. And you want to be able to touch your dog, you want to have control of your dog. So right now, we're going to go into some downs. I've already kind of put it on cue here. I want to do some downstays. So I'm going to go ahead and start it up. Down. Okay, so notice I'm not continually saying the cue over and over again. So I just want to say it once, maybe twice, and then try it again. It's no big deal if he doesn't get it. He doesn't get it, it's no big deal to me. It's not the end of the world. I'm not going to force him down. I'm not going to scream at him, yell at him for doing it wrong, because I'm teaching him what to do right. Down. Good boy. So I toss the treat so he has to get up to get it, so therefore I can put him back in a down. Good boy. And a down again. Down. Good boy. Down. So now I want him to down for like 2 seconds, and then I'm a click treat. Okay. Now what happened there is I didn't ask for it. I only want it. He only gets treats when I ask for it. Okay.
down. Good boy. Good. So he only gets treats and rewarded in the presence of the cue. Come on. And see, I don't have to reach for him or chase him. I just grab the cob. I mean the leash. And here, I'm just stepping on it. Down. One, two, three. Good boy. Down. One, two, three. Good boy. This is a down stay right here. Down. One, two, three, four, five. Good boy. Down. And see, he doesn't get anything for that. When you start to fine tune something like this, when you say the cue, you want it to happen. If you notice when I'm saying the cue, he's walking around, he's fidgeting, he's doing all this stuff. I want to weed that out as soon as possible. Down. Good boy. Stay. Stay. Good boy. Oh, he missed it. Okay. I got it. Let me see it. Oh, wow. It went over here. Get out of here. Back out. Come on. Couple more here. Down. Stay. Stay. And see, now I'm adding a distraction. Good boy. All I'm doing is adding a distraction, waving my hands around. This is a distraction. Down. Perfect. I clicked that one because he went right down. Down. Okay, so it's his loss. I'm not going to beg him to take a treat. It's his loss. If he doesn't go down, you missed out. I'm not going to yell or anything. I'm not going to beg you to take a treat. Good boy. So remember what I said. A down on cue is exactly what we want. Not a down when he feels like it. Okay. Down. Good boy. Stay. Stay. Good boy. So I'm going to do it two more times, and that'll be it. Down. Stay. 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 Good. Good boy. Okay. Down. Okay. Come on. So I give him like 7 seconds in there to respond to the cue. When he doesn't, then that's fine. What happens is if every time I ask him to do something, he waits 7 or 8 seconds and still gets rewarded, then that's what I'm gonna get the next time. So I wanna lower that, what they call latency, it would be nice if I could get 2 seconds, that'd be great. But it's new, you know, it's new to training. Down. Down. Okay, so that's why I wanted to do one more. I don't wanna ask him for too much. Okay, down. So now he's like squinting, it's letting me know I kind of gone too far. So I'm gonna give him something really easy right here. Sit. Sit. Good. So I'm giving him something easy, kind of get him back in the game. Sit. Good. Good boy. Sit. Good. Sit. Good boy. So now I'm gonna ask for the down again. Down. All right, that's good enough. All right, so that's it. And that's kind of just a little manipulation I've seen. I stretched it a little too far. I was losing him. It wasn't that he wasn't really getting it. It's just he wasn't having fun anymore. It's like, dude, it's not really worth it anymore. He's starting to squint some and, you know, look around. So it lets me, these little signs let me know that the training session has gone too far. And these just little subtle signs when you see him and you ask him to do something, and he's giving you all this other stuff, just say, all right, whatever, you know, that's fine.
give him something easy, like that lower sit, bing. And he's like, sweet, I know this, you know. The other stuff is a little newer, so he tends to not get it as quick as the other stuff that has more of a history. He kind of understands it more. The new stuff he's still trying to get and feel out. So down stays, sit stays, self-control with the toy, and other little rules. Definitely with the leash and stuff like that. So you guys have fun.